Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our series in which what we do, we daily discuss some questions relating to your prelims. So we have named this series as Let's Solve Some Questions for Prelims 2020. So as its name suggests, so this series is not just about solving questions, but it is also about your participation. Because we do expect that you people not just solve questions, but also participate in the discussion. And your comments are invited. And if you have any additional information, then do ensure that you share it with us and with others as well in the comment box. And also if you have any queries, doubts, then you are more than welcome to ask us these queries. So let's start our discussion. So today is video number 18 of our discussion. So let's see what are the topics that we will be discussing today. So the first question is, the topic is basically ancient India, and the question is Jaina literature, that is Jaina literature can be found in which of these languages? First Sanskrit, second Prakrit, third Tamil. So we have to choose that which of the above codes is correct. Let me tell you friends that in all these languages the Jaina literature is found in Sanskrit as well, in Prakrit as well, and in Tamil as well. So the answer is D. So Jaina literature is primarily divided between Digambara literature and Shvetambara literature. So it exists mainly in Jaina, Prakrit, Sanskrit, Marathi, Tamil, Rajasthani, Dhundari, Marwari, Hindi, Gujarati, Kannada, Malayalam, Tulu, and more recently in English. So Jains have contributed to India's classical and popular literature. For example, almost all early Kannada literature and many Tamil works were written by Jains. So some of the oldest known books in Hindi and Gujarati were also written by Jain scholars. And this is about your first question. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, in the sculptures found at Mahabalipuram, you are likely to find the depiction of which of these figures? First elephant, second serpent, third bird. So we have to choose the correct answer. So let me tell you friends that we have the answer is D. That is, all these sculptures have been engraved at the monuments that are found at Mahabalipuram. So the answer is D. So here you can see the photograph I have included for your clarification. So you can see here the elephant, and here you can also check the serpents as well as birds. So you have to find it. Actually, I have not seen it personally, but I have read it somewhere that all these sculptures are found there. So yeah, so you can see here the serpents, but then you have to search for birds. You can do so by going to Mahabalipuram if you have the time and have the resources. You are more than we can say welcome to go there. So now let's move. By the 7th century, Mahabalipuram was a port city of South Indian dynasty of the Pallavas. So it has a group of centuries which was carved out of rock along the Coromandel coast in 7th and 8th centuries. So Ratha's temples in the form of karyots and mandaps and gyant, open rock reliefs such as the famous descent of Ganges and the Shore temple with thousands of sculptures to the glory of Shiva, they have been found. So it is not just a single structure. So it is a complex of different structures that are found there. So group of monuments at Mahabalipuram has been classified as UNESCO World Heritage Site. So now let's move to the next question. Next is Rajgir in Bihar is related to which of the following? First Buddhism, second Jainism, third Kingdom of Magadha, fourth Chogyals. So we have to choose the correct answer. So let me tell you friends that the answer is C, that is 1, 2, and 3. So this Rajgir, basically it was the capital city of Magadha earlier, and it is on the basis of Xinjiang in particular that the site is divided into old and new Rajgir. So it is considered as one of the favorite places of Gautam Buddha, and also Mahavira, that is the 24th Tirthankara, spent 14 years of his life at Rajgir and Nalanda. So it was the first capital of the Kingdom of Magadha, a state that would eventually evolve into the Mauryan Empire. So Chogyals were the monarchs of former kingdoms of Sikkim and Ladakh, which were ruled by separate branches of Namgyal dynasty. So fourth is incorrect. Now let's move to the next question. Next is Ashtadhyayi is a compilation of astronomical interpretations by ancient seers, first known description of a binary numeral system, summary and synthesis of the philosophical and spiritual ideas in the Upanishads, D, none of the above. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, that D is the answer. None of these is properly defining Ashtadhyay. So it is basically a Sanskrit treatise on grammar. So it was written in 6th to 5th century BCE by Panini. So almost 2500 years back. So this work set the linguistic standards for classical Sanskrit, and beyond defining the morphology and syntax of Sanskrit language, it also distinguishes usage in spoken language and usage that is proper to the language of the sacred text. So it is the earliest known work on linguistic description, and together with the work of his immediate predecessors, stands at the beginning of the history of linguistic itself. So his theory of morphological analysis was more advanced than any equivalent Western theory before the mid-20th century. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, according to Jain teachings, the cycle of birth and rebirth is shaped through A. Karma, B. Soul's expression, C. Unfolding of human consciousness, and destiny of the universe. So friends, the answer is A, that is karma. So Jain philosophy believed in karma theory. So human moral actions form the basis of the transmigration of soul. So Jain cite inequality, sufferings, and pain as the evidence for the existence of karma. So karmic theory of Jain attaches greater responsibility to individual actions and eliminates any reliance on some supposed existence of divine grace or retribution. So the Jain doctrine also holds that it is possible for us to both modify our karma and to obtain release from it through the austerities and purity of conduct, and asceticism and penance are required to free oneself from the cycle of karma. So this can be achieved only by renouncing the world. Therefore, monastic existence is a necessary condition of salvation. So these are the 5 questions of today. So if your score is 5 or 4 or 3 out of 5, then it is good. But if your score is 0, 1, 2, then it is very much good, because at least you have listened to something which you were not aware earlier. So at least you have come across new facts and concepts, and you have learned something in the you can say in the entire day. So my request to you people here is that don't count your scores. Why I point towards scores, because basically I want to make sure that students get proper idea that why in the beginning it is not good to count scores, especially those who feel that their scores are low. Because if you are getting demotivated by your low scores, then suddenly you will do, ultimately you will stop seeing the videos, or you will stop solving the questions. But that is not the way forward. See the questions and their explanations as a source of learning. Once you see them as a source of learning, then you start improving, because you learn some new facts, some new information, and then you revise it again, and you have better understanding of the topic as the days pass. So obviously as your prelims is 6 months away, so I request you to please be regular and to see these videos, so that at least you must have some confidence in the evening that you have at least something, you have done something for and you have learned something new that would keep you close to your take you close to your goal. So this was about your today's questions. And also, friends, before the closing comments, we have a series that is Modern India series, based upon the Spectrum Publications book, that is a modern history of a brief history of modern India. So in this series, we have decided to complete your syllabus in a time bound manner. So in 45 days your complete book is covered. So you are given daily a target to read out of it, and daily 10 MCQs are given to you from that target, in the evening, and then this way this ensures that your topic gets completed in a time bound and in a regular manner. So not just we have this series about modern India, but also we have series about your Lakshmikant book, that is Indian Polity by M. Lakshmikant, and also we have history NCRT series, geography NCRT series, art and culture series. So all those series are basically to help those students who are preparing from home, so that they can prepare in a time-bound manner, because most of the students face the problem of discipline in the studies. So if in case you are interested to join, then you can check the link. The link is shown on your screen, and this link will also be provided in the description box. So you can check the description box and can see various links and various series that we have for the purpose of CSE preparation. And and also friends, we have a Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen. And in this Telegram channel, we have more than 15,000 students that follow us, and they have access to various resources that we share for the purpose of CSE preparation. So also the discussion, the PDFs of discussions, daily discussions, for example, the PDF of this discussion will also be available in this Telegram channel. So if in case you are interested to get access to various resources that we share for the CSE preparation, then do ensure that you check the description box, because in it we have provided the link of our Telegram channel, and do ensure that you become become a part of our family. So this is all about, friends, today's video. If you have doubts and queries, you can ask in the comment box. So thank you, have a very nice day ahead.